I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. We've got some classic rackets and some cool looking shoes for you this week. Let's jump straight into the shoes. First up, I've got the Nike Air Max Vapor Wing. Now, first thing you need to know about this shoe is it does run about a half size short. So if you say wear a 10, order a 10 and a half to get the perfect fit, 10.5 to get the perfect fit in this shoe. It's also a fairly narrow fitting shoe and it gets its support out there on the court from that narrow glove-like fit. Really wraps the foot very well. You can snug it up nicely with the lace system to really get a secure fit out there. But this is a great shoe for me because I like to wear my tennis shoes off the court too. This has got a ton of casual style to it and a lot of comfort. It's got the Air Max in the heel right there, so you get a nice, comfortable ride and just looks great with a pair of jeans or a pair of shorts when you're off the court, and then you can go straight on the court and rock it for a nice hit. So a beautiful shoe, love that one. Tons of style, just order half size up to get the perfect fit in that Nike Vapor Wing. Next up, we've got a limited edition of the Hypercourt Express here from K-Swiss. This shoe has a much more generous fit in the forefoot. You can see it's got some nice width to it right there. Love this limited edition colorway here. Really cool look to the upper on this one. It's a beautiful, comfortable shoe. It's lightweight, it's breathable. Great traction, solid cushioning from this one. So cool looking shoe and great on-court performance from that one as well. Okay, classic rackets now. Let's have a look first at this Austrian-made Head Prestige Classic. And this is one of Mark Philippoussis' old rackets. And this is when he was between sponsorships. So it's been blacked out, has the Warren Bosworth weight and balance customization to his specs. Still got some of his stringing information on the inside of the throat and the toner grip as it was when it was getting ready for him to take it out on the court. So that's a great option right there for the collector that wants to have a great racket to hit and also a really fun conversation piece in their racket collection. Next up, we've got the Head Graphite Vector, and I love the rounded edges to the beam design on this one. I think it's a beautiful racket. Again, this is one I would probably take out and hit and then also hang on the wall, keep it in my collection too. Just beautiful, classic graphite racket right there. Next up, we've got a really early version of the Wilson Ultra 2, and this one has the introduction to the PWS, perimeter weighting system, and it is this metal piece right here. They're on both sides of the frame at 3 and 9 o'clock, and they're pop riveted on. So this is before you saw the PWS. Later on, it would just be the graphite mold taken out. This is a pop riveted on piece of metal right there to give it that weighting system. Also has a separate throat piece on it too. So a great looking racket, fun one to hit, and some really nice skin pieces to talk about if you have that in your collection. And speaking of rackets that are interesting, we've got this Blackburn DS107, and it's a double strung, and you'll see it's got one string bed here and another one there. So if you do break a string, you have to restring it. Installing the second string bed is going to be a fun endeavor. Indeed, just getting the crosses woven in there is going to be a tricky one. But talk about a maximum spin one. No, it's got 107 square inches, and the strings go right to the edge of the frame. So it's designed to minimize mishits. And if you're taking a really aggressive swing, you could cut this probably at the most acute angle possible for a racket and still find strings. So that is a cool looking racket right there and a great addition to any racket collection. That's all I got for this week. Thank you so much for watching.